our number system and rounding. This video will help you learn whole number place value, learn decimal number place value, and round numbers to a specific place value. Start with whole number place value. The digits, and we use just 10 of these. The digits 0 through 9, we use just 10 digits, and with those 10 digits, we can represent every number in our number system. And we do that through place value. Place value uses the position or placement of the digits in a number to indicate the value of each of the digits. For example, if we have this number right here, $4,562. It has four digits, but that represents $4,562 using just those four digits. And the way we do that is by putting it in a specific place value. So if we look down here, $4,562. Well, that digit 4 doesn't represent 4, it represents 4,000. The 5 represents 500, 6 represents 60, and 2 represents 2. So we can represent with just those four digits a very large quantity here. And when you write a number out in this fashion right here, 4,000 plus 500 plus 60 plus 2, that's called expanded form. So in our number system, every three digits is grouped into a period. And that's why when we write a number after every three digits, we put a comma, because each of those commas separates the periods. So to use our number system, you're going to have to memorize these place value periods. And here they are right here. So we have the ones period, which is the smallest period. Then we go to the thousands, the millions, the billions, and then finally the trillions. Now in each of those periods, the same pattern occurs. So the three digits in each period contain a ones, tens, and hundreds place. So if we're starting right here looking at this first period, which has 890 in it, that's the ones period. But in there we have the ones, the tens, and the hundreds. Now when we go to the next period, which is the thousands period, we still have the same thing, ones, tens, hundreds. Next place value period, the millions, ones, tens, hundreds, so on and so forth. So inside of every period, it always has that pattern, ones, tens, hundreds. So to read a number, all we have to do is read each three-digit group in the period and then state the period. So let's take a look here. I'll read this number for you. So we start in the millions period here, and since there's only a 3, I would just say 3 million. Now we're going to go to the next period, which is the thousands period. And here we have it right there, 507,000, and then 890. So you read the group of 3 digits in the period, and then just state the period afterwards. And notice, when I did the ones period here, I didn't have to say the period. So we say every period except for the ones period. It's kind of understood when we say 890 that that's the ones period. Now let's take a look at some examples that will help you understand how to write a number in words, and then also how to identify certain place values. So example one, write the number 62, and it looks like here we're going to have the ones period, thousands period, millions period, and then finally the billions period. So I would say, okay, 62, that's the digits in the billions period, then I would say, okay, that's billions. So I'd say 62 billion, comma, go to the next period here. Looks like I just have a 2 in that one, so I would say 2, that's the millions period. And then 419. And that's 1,000. And then the last is 36. See, I put a comma right there between the thousands period and the ones period. So 62,2,419,036. Example 2. Identify the place value of the digit 4 in this number. Well, here's our digit 4. Let's see. We're going to go the ones period, thousands period. We're in the millions period now, and we are in the ones, tens. So that is the 10 millions period. Or place value, sorry, not the 10 millions period, but the 10 millions place value. Okay, now let's go ahead and pause your video player and answer these two practice questions, questions 3 and 4 there. And when you're done, hit play to see how you did. Okay, Looking at question three here. Got a very big number. We're going to write this in words. Let's see. It starts out with 2, so I'll say 2. Let's see which period that's in. Here's ones, thousands, millions, billions. So that's 2 billion. And then 2 again. But this one is in the millions place, so 2 million. 712. That's 1,000. And then finally 70. Okay, question 4. Identify the place value of the digit 4 in this number here. So let's see, here's my digit 4. Looks like it's in the thousands place. The thousands period, and in that period, it's in the tens place of that, so that's going to be the 10,000s place. Okay, let's take a look now at decimal number place value. The digits to the left of the decimal point are whole numbers. The digits to the right of the decimal point are fractions. And so here we have our whole numbers. And everything to the right then is going to be fractions. In fact, they used to call these a lot of times decimal fractions because any of these digits over to the right are going to represent a fraction. So the decimal point separates the whole numbers from the decimal numbers or fractions. So the decimal part of 14.7, we don't read that as 0.7, is read as 7/10 because this 0.7 represents the fraction 7/10. And all of the place values to the right of the decimal point, again, they represent fractions. So we're going to have to memorize all of these place values. And so most of the time, or a lot of times, what people are taught is to start at the decimal point and then start with the place values going to the right or the left. Now, that's okay, but there's a better way to do this because the number system is not symmetric to the decimal point. It's actually symmetric to the ones place. And if you kind of use the ones place as the middle or starting point, then notice it's symmetric to either side here. Going to the right from the ones place, one step there, gives me the tenths. Going to the left gives me the tens. Two places to the right gives me the tenths. Two places to the right gives me the hundredths place. And then two places to the left also gives me the hundredths place. So the place values have reciprocal symmetry on either side of the ones place. And that's going to make it easy to remember these place values as we go. Now let's take a look at some examples that will help you understand how to identify place values. Question 5. What is the place value of the digit 5 in this number? Well, let's see. Okay, here's my digit 5. Here's my ones place. And so if I go to the right from there, that's going to be tenths, hundredths, thousandths. So that is in the thousandths place. And so we want to make sure we have a THS on that. That indicates that that's a fraction, 5 out of 1,000. Example 6, write 24.35 in expanded form. Well, we're going to want to write the value of each of these digits. So first we'll start with the digit 2. The digit 2 has a value of 20. Then we'll go to the 4. That's just 4 because it's in the ones place. Now when we get to the 3, that's in the tenths place. So that's the fraction 3/10. And then finally, the last digit, 5, is in the hundredths place, so that's the fraction 5 out of 100. Now, when we write these things in expanded form, we don't want to simplify these fractions. We could simplify 5/100, but it's not necessary here. Okay, and then finally, question 7, write this number in words. So we'd start out and we'd say, okay, 6 is the whole number part. Now, anytime we see a decimal, we're going to use the word and as our separator or to indicate where the decimal point is. Now when I go to read the decimal side of a number, I actually write out the value of that whole thing. So that's 892. So I would write that, 892. And now I want to write the place value of that last digit right there. And so that is in the tenths, hundredths, thousandths. So we would say that's 892 thousandths. With a THS on the end. So go ahead now and pause your video player and answer these practice questions. When you're done, go ahead and hit play to see how you did. Question 8, what is the place value of the digit 2? So here we go, let's see, tenths, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths. So that's in the ten thousandths place. All right. Question 9. Write this number out in expanded form. Well, let's start with the digit 1. That's in the tens place. So that's going to be worth 10. We can write plus 0 here, or you can just not write it at all. Either way is fine. All right. Get to the 2. That's in the tens place. So that's the fraction 2 tenths. 9 is in the hundredths place. So that's the fraction 9 hundredths. And finally, 7 is in the thousandths place. So we'll write 7 over 1,000. Question 10, write this number in words. So I would say, okay, 9, then I want to indicate the decimal, so I use the word and then I want to write the whole number here, which is 34. And that is, then we write the place value of the last digit, which is the 4 there, and so that's in the hundredths place, so 34 hundredths. Round numbers to a specific place value. So identifying the best approximation for a number to a certain place value is called rounding. And that's what we're doing when we're rounding. We're finding an approximation for a number. We're trying to work with a number that's a little bit easier than the original number, and we don't need all of this accuracy. That's why we round. And so here are 3 steps we use when we round. Step 1, we're going to circle the digit that's going to be rounded. Step 2, decide if this digit to be rounded increases by 1 or stays the same. Now, you've often heard rounding down, but in fact, when we round a number down, that digit just stays the same. So that's a common mistake students make, so be careful with that. When we round down, the digit itself actually stays the same. So decide whether we're going to increase the digit by 1 or keep it the same. We look to the digit to the right of the rounded one. And so if that digit is between 0 and 4, we're going to keep it the same. If that digit to the right is between 5 and 9, we're going to go ahead and round the number up. After we round this digit, then every digit to the right of the rounded digit is going to go to 0. Now let's take a look at some examples that will help you understand how to round. Let's see here. Example 11. Round 1,562 to the nearest hundredths place. So what we want to do here is we want to circle the digit that's in the hundredths place, and that is the 5. Okay? Now we need to decide whether if that 5 is going to stay the same or if it's going to go up 1. If it stays the same, you know, if this thing goes up 1, that digit goes up 1, we're going to get an answer of this. 1,600. Remember, it's going to go up 1 and then everything to the right of it will be zeros. If it stays the same, we're going to get an answer of 1,500. We want to choose the number that's the best approximation for the original. And notice, this 1,600 is closer to the original value than 1,500. So that's where we're going to want to round. So you can kind of look at this and use your intuition about this as well, you know, to round these things. If we use our rules, we would just do this. We would look to the right here. The 6 is going to tell us whether we're going to round this digit up or it's going to stay the same, and it can say it's greater than 5, or it's 5 or greater, so that means we're going to round that 5 up. So we would say, okay, 1, 6, and then every digit after the rounded one now is going to go to 0, and we get 1,600. So either way you look at this, kind of looking at your two choices and just getting the best approximation or using our rule, we should end up with 1,600 there. All right, question 12. Round this number to the nearest 10 thousandths place. All right, well, let's see. There's the ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10 thousandths. So the 1 is the digit that we're going to run around. And if you look to the right here, the digit to the right is a 2. So that means we want to keep this 1 the same. So that 1 is going to stay the same. Now, after this digit that we're rounding, everything is going to 0. So that means that 2 is no longer going to be in my answer. So we're going to get 10,000 for our rounded value there. Go ahead and pause your video player now and answer these 2 practice questions. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. Question 13. We're going to round this number to the nearest thousands place. So let's see, the thousands place is the 7. So we want to circle that digit. Looking to the right here, that 5 tells us we need to round this 7 up 1. So we're going to get 18 now. Every digit after this rounded digit now is going to 0. So we're going to get 18,000. question 14. We want to round this number to the 100,000s place. All right, let's see. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, 100,000s. So we're going to look to the right. And that 4 now is telling us we better keep this 1 the same. So the 1 is staying the same. That's our rounded digit. Everything to the right now is going to 0 after that. So we're going to get 100,000 for our answer there. Go ahead and pause your video player again now and answer these more of these practice questions about rounding now to decimal place values. We've thrown some decimal place values in there. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. Okay, question 15. We're rounding this number to the hundredths place. So that's going to be the 7. We look to the right. That's a 3. That tells us that 7 is going to stay the same. So we should end up with 5 and 87 hundredths. Question 16. We're rounded to the tenths place, which is the 0. It's okay to round to 0. No different than the other ones. We're looking to the right. That 9 is telling us we better round this 0 up 1. So we're going to get a final answer there of 40 and 1/10. Question 17, we're rounding to the hundreds place. Now be careful, that's hundreds, not hundredths. So we're going to come over here and the 3 is in the hundreds place. We look to the 4, that's telling us to keep that 3 the same. So 1,300. We don't need to write any of these digits over here after the decimal. That would only make our number harder to work with. And when we're rounding, we're trying to make the number easier to work with. So right there, 1,300 is our answer. 18, we're rounded to the 10,000s place. So let's see, tens, tenths, hundredths, thousands, 10,000s. So the 5 is our digit. The 7 to the right tells us we better round that 5 up 1. So let's see, 50.0066 for our answer there.